Anurag Batra, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief, Exchange for Media and Business World Group, to say a few words here, sir.
Morning. It's my honor and privilege to be here. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge my friends who are also stalwarts, pioneers, and in some way the creators of this domain, you know, because they're pioneers. So I'd like to welcome somebody who really doesn't need any introduction to this community or in the business and the political community in India, Mr. Dilip Serian. Please give him a big round of applause, because he's been an icon and a role model for a lot of us. I keep telling him, when I grow up, I want to be like him. See, I'm trying hard, Dilip. We have our keynote speaker, who's come specially from Singapore, and he's from Ketchum. I'm trying to get your name right, Mr. John Bailey. Welcome, Mr. Bailey. Please give Mr. Bailey a big round of applause.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. I was just reflecting when I was on the way here to Delhi yesterday. It's actually a little over 20 years since I first came here for a business reason. And at that time, I was working in the airline industry, helping airlines with crisis communications. In other words, protecting their reputation. And the big challenge at that time was not social media. It was 24-hour rolling cable and satellite TV channels, CNN. Nobody had even thought about social media at that time. Today, we live in a very, very different environment. Now, my day job, as you've just been told, is I run a PR agency in Singapore, that's Ketchum. But I also spend a lot of time working with airlines, with hotel groups, and other clients on defending reputation.
Thank you very much. It's good to be here in Delhi after some time from Australia. Now, we've just heard a great opening address by John Bailey, and I think some of the things which we'll be talking about he's already touched upon things like sort of crisis management and brand reputation. Our guests here are sort of accomplished speakers and thought leaders in the industry. So I will just open the panel very quickly.
Last month at an event in conference, and P&G has the largest budget. His single point message to us as communicators was storytelling is the key to effective brand engagement. He is not the biggest fan of advertising any longer, and he put forward certain examples of how great content and great storytelling in the internet world or in the digital world actually created better engagement and better outcomes for his business.
The other thing that spreads pretty fast online is funny stuff. Right now, I don't say that particular video you can respond to with a funny comment, but there is much fake news which is patently wrong about brands that can be tackled, I believe, with a healthy dose of humor. And that's going to get far more velocity than a very plain Jane vanilla CEO speaking saying, I'm sorry. So say the sorry, but then put that out. So I'll end with that. Thank you.
What enhances real intelligence? So a lot of us tend to mistake tools for what the progress actually is. So what artificial intelligence does, of any kind, and I'm going out on a limb to say this, till we reach the third generation of artificial intelligence, which is when cognitive technologies start speaking to each other and ignore all of us, that fortunately is not likely for the next 3 years.
I think, you know, in the old days, I used to believe the Forex trader was the only one who would get burnt out really quickly. But I think in our industry, that's happening too, because the pace at which we need to run and the diverse sort of opportunities that we need to chase are just multifold. And I find the younger people are able to keep pace with it.
I mean, I'll just talk about in terms of a technology industry. A few years ago, job specs were written as good as product specs. Has to be efficient, has to be productive, zero downtime, has to have a backup. So it sounded like you needed a product made in a factory and not a person.
I think across various functions, whether it's trade marketing, whether it's brand management, or even digital managers, obviously, I think everybody needs to be aware of the basic minimum of how the ecosystem operates and how you can make a story go big you know, that basic understanding of what marketing entails. And the other would be culture. You know, I don't think you can be a marketer today and, you know, I hear from some people, some of the marketing people, that we don't watch Hindi movies. And I'm like, what? How do you market in India unless you understand Bollywood? So that cultural sensitivity and knowing your consumers and what makes them buzz and tick is essential. So these two, I think, culture and digital.
So, Nandini, honestly, when I look at hiring someone, to my mind, skills are there, but it's really about the attitude. Because the reality of our lives today is that what technology is, you know, cutting edge today, a year down the line, you know, it'll be passe. So at the end of the day, you've got to have somebody who's constantly, who's curious, who's willing to learn, unlearn, you know, constantly keep upping the...
I would actually put it two ways. One, today it's all about omni-channel. It's no longer one channel, retail, digital, or brand, or marketing. It's actually omni-channel. So I constantly, I keep seeing how it's from online to offline, offline to online, and there is no such boundary which exists today.
Now, of course, we've heard in the morning about fake news. What I would like to ask each one of the panelists, in their, just in a few words, what is each one of their company that they've seen do to try and help?
Fake news is something that everyone's trying to counter. What we're missing, of course, is that unlike something like New Yorker, which has a huge desk of fact checkers, and I think, I guess you can make out the importance of tracking fake news from the fact that there are...
I think, look, the question that you have raised is, to my mind, it's a very stereotypical question. And the reason why I say that is that we are now in the world of post-truth, as it's often described. Truth is it based on facts? What are facts? You know, I may choose to say that this bottle is half full. You may say that it's half empty.
Journalism 101 takes care of about 95% of the filters that you need to ensure that you know, fake news does not go through your platforms or your channel.
Facebook. Why? And what is that? Fang, Amazon, Netflix, Google, whatever.
No, that you can say the branding would have changed for many of these eminent writers who would say that, you know, we need a reason to put a version 2, a version 3, a version 4, a version 5. And we have heard about branding 2.0, branding 3.0 may come up. These are all terminologies. But if you go to the essence of branding, I don't think branding's changed.
So, for example, I find the CEO today is also the chief marketing officer of his style of brand working in a corporate environment. And I find that to be quite interesting because there are, CEOs out there who are not on social media that often. But I see, especially in Australia, that CEOs are talking about their personal philosophy, which is actually in sync with the company they work for.
In some ways, I believe brand's not changed. But I think now, as a marketing person, as a CEO, or in general, I believe now the brand has so many more moments in which it has to be true. So imagine like a 10-year-old ago, if a Maruti car delivered on performance, on mileage, that's the brand it built. Today, imagine for him, his brand ambassador may go out and tweet something, you know, which is not in his control eventually. So the number of times a brand now needs to be true across social media, across content, across PR.
She was a reporter. She's worked extensively in the media. She has friends in the media. And she crossed over to politics. So she understands our domain. She understands journalism. She understands communication. She joined the Aam Aadmi Party and now is the spokesperson for the Bhartiya Janata Party. Ghanshyam Tiwari again went to a top-notch business school, one of the IIMs. He's an edutech entrepreneur and he's a Samajwadi Party spokesperson. And last but not the least, Mr. Khan, because I don't know you well, I know them. I know Shazia really well. And I know Ghanshyam a little bit, so I can talk to them. Are there any channels that are biased?
Well, is there any channel which is not?
So tell us the names of some of the biased channels.
No,
and their biases.
I think we have a fair idea of channels which turn to veer to one side of the spectrum or the other. But I think, you know, this whole idea of journalistic bias is the reason that there has to be objectivity, I think, remains very utopian. because I have been a journalist, I passed out from a film school, and there are certain biases you live with. And if you really believe what you do, if you've been indoctrinated or been trained to think a certain way, you do vilify one side and not the other. So true objectivity can be utopian and difficult to achieve, can be very elusive. Having said that, there remains a responsibility for every input head, reporter, correspondent, producer, to present both sides.
Relating to two questions, one discourse, other is channel bias. I am not worried about bias of channels. Biases emerge from life experience. What I am worried about is agenda setting. And when television becomes a media where the agenda is not of the people, each television channel has its own loyal audience and then some floating audience. When the agenda does not respond to people, the platform loses its credibility. As a spokesperson, I have believed that in the last 2-3 years, there was a concerted effort to ensure that television as a platform loses credibility for public debate.
How we do research in the Congress party, we have a very streamlined cell. Over the last 4 years, our cell has become extremely professional and amazing. Now, for example, in the BJP or in the Samajwadi party, channels get...
So you have a troll brigade too?
No, we don't actually.
You don't have a troll brigade? Nobody has a troll brigade.
No, no. At least we don't. It's okay. For Shazia ji to say whether her party does
or not. No, I didn't refer to their party, okay?
But I'll tell you something. Look, research. I believe that discourse, which is purely based on rhetoric, comes with an expiry date.
And the women do it really well. If you look at it professionally, or homemakers, or tier two, which Neha touched upon, or what Paroma said about breaking stereotypes, it is very important for us to remember there are three things that drive women. It's strength, it's knowledge, and it's wanting to be prosperous. Women today are not here to do what others can't do, and I'm not talking about men. It's about what others can do, can't do. Women achieve everything possible in today's world.
So the commission is working. For the first time in the history of the nation, we have a commission which is at least trying, which we are really trying hard. I'm very proud to say that we are the only commission in the country which functions officially on Saturdays. Unofficially, we are working on Sundays during nights. While my predecessor for 8 years handled only one case, in 3 years, we've handled more than 55,000 cases, attended over 2.16 lakh calls on our 181 helpline, done 75,000 grassroots visits, assisted 36,000 sexual assault survivors in various court cases, 11,000 counseling sessions, over 200 recommendations to the government.
Really, I feel like this is a very good opportunity, and all of you will never meet again in one room. But tell me something, you give so much attention to digital. And you know, in the age where you know that a lot of people, 90% of the people that you see have content on YouTube and everywhere, they've got paid likes. It's a real world, right? Let's face it. Unke aadho ke likes jo hain, aapko pata hai ki shayad real bhi nahi hai. So how do you as an agency, like for example, the PR agencies over here, how do you decide ki kis pe kitna business jana chahiye? When you know that, for example, radio hai, ya print hai, ya television hai, unki ratings hai, kuch hai, whatever. And you know, aur dusri taraf jo hai digital pe, and I'm not pointing fingers, I'm just playing devil's advocate here. Because I also create a lot of digital content. But how do you decide ki kisko kitna tawajjuh dena? Because, you know, it might just be a bubble which might burst one day. What do you feel?
One thing I'd like to add to that. You asked about confrontation.
Yeah.
And I'm talking in English because this was a lecture in English. We've all heard of Shekhar Kapoor. He's an amazing film director. He is the one guy who, there's another film director like him, who's an Indian who's made Hollywood content, films that have been a success story, and also Hindi films. This was 3 years ago in Goa at Film Bazaar. He was giving a talk and he spoke about the fact that Variety, and this is 3 years ago, Variety magazine had done this survey, not in India, but the rest of the world, and had found that the millennium bachcha, that's children born from the year 2000 onwards, who do they respect, who do they acknowledge? And what they found was that any child born after the year 2000, this is a big generalizing, all of their heroes were not Hollywood, Bollywood, sports, or people who wrote books. And people actually became quite angry about this. And then he started naming them. People had never heard the names. These were all YouTubers. But today, I'm sure if he's speaking exactly the same thing, there won't be that sort of reaction. Because now people are waking
up. Today is to look at broadcast technology we have talked about.
search engine optimization techniques, social media marketing techniques?
Good question. I think technology has changed the way we communicate. And like I mentioned earlier, I think first and foremost, you need people to write content in a different way, in a different format. Today, insights and analytics are going to play a major part as we tell new stories.
Yes.
And to understand insights analytics, you need to understand a lot of the technology behind it.
Original content.
Original content is what you have seen from your own eyes. So personalization is very important over here.
So I think non-media reputational work is very important for B2B audiences. Mm-hmm. What you can do with advocacy, mm-hmm. what you can do with industry groups, mm-hmm. what you can do through the government, through a campus with young entrepreneurs.
Okay.
So, similar things where you can actually spread your message mm-hmm. or have long-term policy impact mm-hmm. Through a variety of engagement initiatives which are not necessarily media-driven. So I would just say stay focused. Stay
okay.
focused as to what you want to do and be really very good at it, because unless and until a lot of young people ask me, particularly communications people, that, you know, I don't get a seat at the table. My CEO doesn't listen to me. What have you done to make your CEO listen to you?
Mm-hmm.
Be really, really credible in what you do, the advice you give, the value you bring to the table. Unless and until you have credibility, nobody is going to listen to
yeah.
you. So be very focused, work really hard at being good, and be credible.
Very warm welcome to the 9th edition of the India PR and Corporate Communications Awards 2018.
I think 2019 is going to be from the year of consolidation to the year where private equity and management buyouts hit our industry within holding companies. My prediction for this is, I predict Hilton Knowlton is going to be taken out of WPP and is going to be bought by private equity or be taken over by a management buyout. WPP is ignoring its PR assets, it's underinvesting in its PR assets, it does not have the money to continue to invest in intellectual capital, to invest in clients and invest in people. I think it's terrible. I think the future of our industry, marketing communications, marketing services, is privately held companies, because we have smaller expectations for margins. We can invest in intellectual capital. We can invest in technology. We don't have to pay attention to quarterly earnings. We can play a long-term game. I think marketing services is a long-term game. So welcome private equity into the industry next year, going after holding companies. Prediction here is Hill and Moulton taken out of WPP by private equity or by management buyout.
आपकी यात्रा के दौरान आपकी कार का इंजन जूझता है गर्मी से स्लज से और घिसाव से हराइए गर्मी को स्लज को और घिसाव को सुरक्षा की ढाल से सर्वो फ्यूचुरा जी प्लस सिंथेटिक इंजन ऑयल आपके कार इंजन की सुरक्षा ढाल जो दे ईंधन में 2% की बचत भी सर्वो फ्यूचुरा जी प्लस इंडियन ऑयल की पेशकश
टेररिज्म का कोई चेहरा नहीं होता उसका धर्म सिर्फ पैसा और हमारा धर्म Duty.
This is the Range Rover Evoque from Land Rover.
Redmi wants to spoil its customers with a lot of options. They have offered the Redmi 7. Here I have the phone with myself.
Watch Living Cars and Tech at this time on newsX.
We will ensure that we have a much more simplified GST system, not the drama-prone, error-prone, chaos-prone GST which Mr. Modi unleashed on us. And we are certainly not going to do any damage to the economy like demonetization. I can't believe that people still give them any credibility after what they've done to India and to our economy.
BJP, which is currently at about 273 seats in parliament, it probably dropped to about 170 or even 150. They thought that Puluwama, the airstrikes, the nationalism debate will get some purchased. I think that initial euphoria has died down.
मजबूत है या कांग्रेस?
70% बीजेपी हो चुकी है।
कितना करप्शन है? सिविक इश्यूज में तो रिलेटेड है ना?
आपसे पहले हम कहते हैं कि एमसीडी करप्ट है, सब करप्ट नहीं है, एमसीडी में भी अच्छे अधिकारी हैं।
एक कर्टन रेजर बनाया है आपने
कि भारत की गलियों से हो रहा मुहूर्त है, एक बार और हमें मोदी की जरूरत है। दिल्ली के दिल में अब हिंदुस्तान है, मोदी है।
Officially over, I think another 5-10 minutes will get to
Congress. President Rahul Gandhi said this time around,
Assam and RC matters, Supreme Court observed that it seems
Congress was actually for 29 years.
Getting an information that he is hiding in the forest
from our viewers and a response to the Pakistani journalist.
Congratulations to all the winners. Yeah.
The silver award goes to
this year had increased.
This is the second time that I am judging these awards.
The award. Misha Mantra! Congratulations! I started my career with Banyan 360. So Kunal, whatever we have achieved, there is something which I always wanted for people like to say on the stage that this is a wonderful thing we have done.
I would like to thank the jury members for seeing the potential in Kaizen PR and awarding us such a brilliant award, I would say. Thank you so much.
Thank you to my entire team. I think it's been great to be recognized in our 20th year.
What goes to Ad Factors PR?
All the wonderful clients of Ad Factors, 330 of them, and the 50-odd large projects that we do.
And the winner is Deepak Kapoor, Godrej Industries.
I believe IPRGC is a very good platform. The industry needs recognition, and I think platforms like these are very essential.
This overall, in overall excellence, is PR Professional of the Year. And without being the AB, I'm naming the winner is Kunal Kishore, Value 360.
In the back end. So thank you everybody, thank you Julie, thank you Anurag, Naval, and the entire team of Exchange Theatre.
I would again like to thank all of the partners who have been part of these awards. This award is presented by Ad Factors PR, Knowledge Driven Communications, and co-powered by Media Monitor, MSL, Publicis Groups, Public Relations and Integrated Communications Network. Co-goal partners are Kaizen, Avian, V, Business Driven Communications, PR Pundit, Urban Mobility Partner, Uber, Lifestyle PR Partner, Active India PR, Lifestyle Experts, Creativity Partner, Weber Shandwick, Digital media partners, Media Value works serving enterprises with B2B communication needs. Knowledge partner, policybazaar.com, compare, buy, save. Academic partner, Pearl Academy. Associate partner, Broadridge. And co-partners, Tech100, Wired Differently, the Publicis, Communication Council, and the Commune. The TV partner is newsX. Advertising partner, Intact Advertising, Visibility Online and Skyline. Gifting partner, BioIWeather. Live webcast partner, 24 Frames Digital. For the last award, under the category of overall excellence, which is a lifetime achievement award, the winner is Mr. Madan Behel of Art Factors.
Who won so many wonderful awards today, or the Mahindras, or the Birlas, or the Hindujas, or the so many of them, they all conglomerates at for the State Bank or the Axis Bank. And we can keep naming them, or the Vodafones or the Samsungs. It will take me 1 hour to just recount all the names of current clients, and many of them have been 5 years, 7 years, 10 years journey. So they enrich you. And of course, the folks at Adventist PR.